Alright, so in the last video, we said that the very first thing that you need to do to be able to make one of these educational videos is to get the information that you want onto your screen. Now, if you're a Red Rocks faculty member interested in making one of these instructional videos, you should be able to get one of these tablets, hopefully from John Johnson. This is a tablet, the company is Wacom, and this is going to help you write things onto your screen if you don't have a tablet specifically or a tablet PC. So right out of the box, I opened it up, and the three important things in the box are the tablet itself, the cord that allows you to connect it to your computer, and the pen, the stylus. So I have never attached this to this computer here, so we're going to see together what happens when we plug this in. I'm going to take that end of the cord, and I'm going to plug it into the only place it plugs into. And I'm going to take the other end and just connect that to the USB port on my laptop here. And we're going to see together what happens when we do that. It's going to take a while. It's going to make my video boring. We're going to have to edit this thing out. All right, so a little box popped up on my screen. This thing right here says installing device and driver software. If you want to see what's happening, you can click that. Okay, that literally took, I think it was 4 minutes, which would have made for a really boring video, so I'm going to have to cut all that out. But now it says it's ready to use, so I'm going to try it out. Now, what this tablet actually does, technically, is it gives you a way to control your mouse from this tablet. So if I take this stylus and I put it somewhere near the stylus, you can see I can move my mouse around on the screen. Of course, in most cases, it's easier to control your mouse with your mouse. But anyway, I'll show you how to use this to start writing things onto your screen. What you want to do is you want to open some program that allows you to write into the program. So if you've never used it before, your computer, if you work here at Red Rocks, should be equipped with Office, the Office Suite, and that should include Microsoft OneNote. So if you go to Start, Programs, Microsoft Office, and click OneNote, the program should open up something that you can write on. There it is. How to flip a classroom, video number three. How to set up and use the tablet here. So now that Microsoft OneNote is open, now you can see that as I write on this tablet, things start to show up onto the screen. And if you flip the stylus over, that's actually an eraser. So you can press down and erase whatever you just wrote. So I'm going to try it out. It is a little awkward when you first start to use it because you're writing down here and you're watching what you're writing up here. But let's test. Oh, see what just happened there? So I need to lower the stylus a little bit and just write test of Wacom tablet. And you can see that my writing looks like I'm about 6 years old. So I'm going to get rid of that. And obviously, it's just going to take a little bit of practice. I wrote too big there, and nothing I wrote was very legible. So you kind of have to get used to using it. So anyway, if you're a Red Rocks employee, you should have one of these tablets. You should have a laptop that's been given to you. You can set this up now. You can write whatever you want on your screen, and you can record that using what we'll talk about in the next video. So before you go, here's video quiz number three, which is written incredibly legibly with my new tablet. You want to set up your tablet and write something in OneNote. And if you want to prove to me that you did that, OneNote's pretty cool because it has the ability to save things as a PDF. So you can save this as a PDF, and feel free to save that thing wherever you want, and you can bring that file in with you to class. Okay, that's it. I hope that was pretty easy for you. I'll see you in the next video where we're actually going to talk about how to do a screen capture of all of this to start making a video.